Let's see how we can use if-else statement with for loop in Excel VBA. On this sheet, I have some data. This data has name, age, city, favorite game, and I have two conditions. First condition is if age is 30, that I'll check in column C. Second condition is favorite game equal to cricket, so that I'll check in column E. So let's see what is the VBA code that we can use here. I'll go to developer tab, click on insert. From ActiveX control, I'll select command button. Let me double click on this command button so that I can write VBA code on the click event of this command button. So code is, first I'll declare two variables. Let me write dim age as integer, dim favorite game as a string. Now I'll assign value from Excel sheet to these variables. So first I'll check only in row number 2. So in row number 2, we have age in column C, that is column 3. Favorite game in column E, that is column 5. So VBA code we can use here, age equal to worksheets, then I'll give sheet name. Sheet name is sheet 1 where we have data. Dot cells. Now row number is 2. Age we have in C column. So column is 3. Dot value. And then favorite game equal to same code, worksheets, sheet 1 dot cells, row number 2. Here we will use column 5 for column E dot value. Once we have assigned values, then I'll use if age is less than 30, then what should happen? Then I want worksheets sheet 1 dot cells row number 2 column F, that is column 6 dot value. If any of these two conditions is matched, then I want good keyword written in column F. So here I can say good. For second condition, else if favorite game equal to cricket, then what should happen? We can observe once I hit enter, then formatting is done automatically if we have written code correctly. So let me copy this line. If favorite game equal to cricket, then also I want good keyword written in column F. Let me show you here in column F. Now, if any of these two conditions is not matching, then what I want, that I'll capture here in else clause. Then I want value as no match. After this line, I can close if statement using and if. Now let me minimize this VBA editor window and see if this code is working. Let me click on design mode so that we are out of design mode. Once I click on this command button, we can see that good keyword is written. Now I want to evaluate entire data. So I have data till row number 21. So what I can do is I can use a for loop for I equal to from second row to 21st row, because first row is only column headings. Next, now this I variable which I have used for loop, I will replace and mention here. So instead of a static row, row will be driven by variable that I have used in for loop. So wherever we have row, we can replace with for loop variable. Now let me minimize this view editor and see if this is working. Once I click on this command button, we can see that all the data is evaluated and values are there basis on the conditions we have written. So let me show the VBA code again. So this code can be used for different requirements with some modifications into it. I hope this tutorial is helpful. If you have any question around this topic, write into comments and subscribe to my channel for more Excel VBA tutorials. Thank you.